Be advised that the views and opinions of the hosts and guests do not reflect those of the station.
Hello, my name is Harrington Watko. Welcome back to the show. We're back to work. It's a Monday. Now, let's see what exactly has gone on the past week. Ladies and gentlemen, there is panic in Malacañang. No less the president came out last Wednesday and forcefully pronounced he does not steal any funds. Hindi siya nagnanakaw at hindi sila magnanakaw. Pero ang questionin po natin, sino sila? Inisip-isip namin po yun, ano? Ang sila pala, yung mga senador na kalaban niya. Bakit? Kasi tatakbo silang presidente, hindi naman siya pwede tumakbo ulit, di ba? But 2016, he's gone. And the three senators, except for the old man, may have political ambitions. But why not? Isn't that what the senators think they are, the next presidents? Because they have no real constituencies. 2 weeks ago, I had a guest here, Carmen Pedrosa, a columnist, editorialist, and she came up together with her associate, former Chief Justice Renato Puno, a people's initiative, but using what we call the internet, or what she calls crowdsourcing. Now, it's slightly different, meaning she wants to amplify wherein the people will come together to discuss the issues basically for one singular strategic move, charter change, using initiative. Now, what recourse do we have in the country where we see the pork barrel scams? Let's not forget, even though the president negates the issue, DAP is just as big an issue together with his presidential social fund and what other malampaya fund, you know, discretionary in other words. What is the difference with all these issues when the pork or the money of the people is being wasted elsewhere? We don't even have a proper accounting, and the only accounting we do get are all against the opposition of the current political party the president belongs to. Don't you find that queer? Alam mo, magtataka po kayo, no? Hindi naman dapat porkit liberal party ka, anghel ka na, tsaka maayos ka na. I don't think so. Not really. Let's remember, we're talking of families who've been in power and in position for the last 6-7 decades. We call them dynasties. But the proper term is actually oligarchs. These ogres, I like to call them, have been there for decades. And they're the real reason why the country remains impoverished. Alan Paguia, last night, mentioned in the TV show, as he puts it, we have all this money. And yet, we have to ask the Red Cross and the civilians to donate to the victims of Bohol, the storms, the flooding, Zamboanga, sa dami ng bilyon ng pera ng Pilipinas, sa dami ng savings ng DAP, wala naman tayo nakikitang bagong kalye o tulay, ni magluto ng pagkain para sa mga tao na pinsala, ni hindi binibigay, bibigay ano, bigas, canned goods, saan kaya nila niluluto? I don't understand. We have all this money, but we can't seem to feed the Filipinos. Where? And yet, by the same news, nakikita natin we have 30, 40, 50 billionaires. Dollar, ha? Hindi peso. Dollar billionaires in this country. Where do you think they make their money? As Alan Paguia says. Tama, no? Hindi naman nila kinikita sa Americans, sa ibang bahay, hindi sa Pilipino. Yumayaman sila based on international standards. Pinagkikitaan ng Pilipino yung nagiging mas pobre. Ladies and gentlemen, there's so many issues to discuss. You've got the pork barrel, which the president is panicking. As of today, the newspaper says in its headline that President Noynoy is willing to discuss the DAP issues with his critics. Critics? Hell, we already marched, di ba? Tagal na natin sinasabi ito. Ang ibig po sabihin ng pork barrel, Mr. President, discretionary. And in your case, how many, you're what, spending or you have the power, the discretion for what, 1 trillion? Hindi ba parang sobra yun? Parang ang buong Kongreso, ang buong Senado, ang buong executive, lahat na ikaw na lahat. Hindi ang tawag dyan diktator. A dictator with legality, hawak mo Supreme Court kasi takot sa'yo, tinanggal mo yung, binayaran mo yung mga senador para tanggalin yung Chief Justice. Ladies and gentlemen, I can go on and on and on, but I'm not going to do a monologue. With us, we have a very formidable group who I met sometime early this year when I joined the Kapatiran Party. And I met this very strong advocate. They weren't asking for positions in the election. They were only pushing an advocacy they believe. And I met them again in the forefront, if not center stage, in the Million People March. I'm talking about MAD. I'm talking about the group against the movement, against dynasties. Tama nga naman. But let's not forget, ha, hindi na dynasty issue lang ngayon, as they will explain to you. We have the chairman, we have Quintin Paredes San Diego, who we've guested here in this show about 6 months back. Movement Against Dynasty, the chairman. And we also have Mr. Edgar T. Bakungan, who's also with MAD, the crusade against the dynasty and corruption. Ladies and gentlemen, ang topic po natin. They'll explain it to you. One time, big time. Ano nga ibig sabihin yan, Ting? One time, big time. Yun ang unahin natin kasi yun ang topic eh.
Magandang pakinggan yan dahil sa tagal-tagal ng panahon na sumama tayo sa lahat ng mga movements having the same advocacies, although different issues, pero iisa lang. Ang solusyon nila ay pare-pareho. Kaya napag-usap-usapan namin na bakit hindi na lang natin gumawa tayo ng paraan o isang proposal na gusto nating iano sa programa mo, Harry, ngayong araw na ito, na i-launch natin. Ito yung proposal natin na one time, big time. So ang ibig sabihin nito, Harry, sa lahat ng mga organisasyon na talagang gusto na baguhin lahat itong mga kawalang iyan, na ginagawa mismo ng ating mga nanunungkulan sa gobyerno ay bawakasan na. Ito sa tingin namin, ito na lang ang huling pagkakataon ng peaceful revolution. Ito i-involve natin ang taong bayan. Ngunit ang una nating dapat i-involve dito ay lahat yung mga grupo-grupo na mayroong mga advocacy against dynasty, against pork barrel, against FOI, DAP, at lahat kasi yan, nasa lugar na, nasa sa husgado na. Pero matapos man lahat yan, hindi natin alam kung anong kararatnan yan, kung tayo ay mananalo o hindi. At lahat ng effort ng lahat ng taong yan at ng buong bayan ay yung People's Initiative through the signature campaign where we are tasked by the government to secure 5.5 million signatures, 3% of which should come from each congressional district.
Kaya ba yan? Di ba nag-launch na tayo, Edgar, ng initiative? You launched it. Kapatiran also launched it.
Yes, yes.
That pick up yung that other group. Ang dami naglo-launch niyan eh.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, there are about 20 organizations. 20? Okay. With different issues, no? At ito ang malungkot, no? The problem is that why we Filipinos are not succeeding, it's because we don't have unity. Kaya nga ito ipanawagan sa ating mga kababayan. Ako, during my college days, talagang aktivista na ako. But legitimate lahat ang issues. But when it comes to the implementation, wala na, watak-watak. So this time, nakita natin that the issues here are concerns to everyone. As a matter of fact, hindi lang yung pork, hindi lang yung FOI, hindi lang yung dynasty. The biggest problem now is Mindanao. The peace process that they're
trying. Mindanao din niya.
Kaya, you know, may Saba pa. So ito, para minsan na hindi piecemeal ang solution dito eh, sa ating problema, sa ating bansa. It should be a one-time, big time. So if the charter changed, yun. Pag charter change niya, lahat na yan, yung FOI, yung pork barrel, yung anti-dynasty, yung corruption and economic reforms campaign, Mindanao campaign, lahat, it's all there. The only way, the thing to do is that magkaroon tayo na, we will have a referendum, and then we will elect our constitutional convention delegate to arrest, address. To solve the, address this problem. In other words, ikaw, Apo Ting Sanjay, you can run as a constitutional convention delegate, ako rin at ikaw din, Sir Harry, to run also and be there. At ito'y pag-usapan, we have all the time to discuss about this. Hindi ngayon, ura-urada gagawa tayo ng petition and then we will campaign for signature. My God, we are wasting time. Don't you know that every second of this country, kada segundo lang, ninanakaw ang pera natin. And so, what we need now is time. And the shortest time is for the signature campaign for the referendum tong charter change.
So,
shortcut na yan.
Hindi, one time big nang, big time. Ang tawag dyan, all-encompassing.
All
lahat ng issues na.
All yes. Issues with it.
All the issues na. Pero ang strategiya natin, gamitin natin ang initiative to force Congress to put out a law for a constitutional charter change.
No, referendum yun. It's the COMELEC. Through the COMELEC.
Through the COMELEC.
And
Congress.
Then the people.
Hindi
the,
kailangan.
Hindi kailangan. No Congress. Need for Congress.
Tao.
So, tao mismo.
Pero can we trust the COMELEC? This institution has been damaged with these commissioners, led by Snow White, called the PICOS.
I know. Yeah, I know. But I know,
I mean,
that. Yeah.
Can we believe this? I mean, even Carmen Pedrosa herself and her group, they all negate the integrity. COMELEC is not a brand. It's created by the leaders who stay the power today.
This would be different.
Yes,
this one. No. Why?
Explain.
Why? Because, you know, in the PICOS, there are many candidates. But this one, there is only one issue.
One issue.
And all the Filipino people are focused on this.
Yes or no?
Yes or no?
Alam mo naman, PICOS, ang tawag dyan, smart nga eh. Ang tawag dyan, magic.
By that time, there will be a new COMELEC chairman.
At tatanggalin na natin si...
I think, if it is done today, this year,
yes,
aabot pa si chairman, chairman Brillantes. Brillantes. Because his term will expire on 2015.
Kasi ngayon, ang nangyayari ngayon, bawat isang issue, iba-ibang movement ang concern.
Na, iba-iba na eh. Lamagane, no?
At nagpo-push.
Correct.
Before we know it, alam mo, nung una, anti-dynasty lang tayo.
Correct,
bigla lumabas na itong pork barrel, andyan na yung PDAP, andyan na yung... lumalabas na yung mga issues. Hindi pa natin alam, in the future, baka meron na namang issue.
Nag-gera na nga sa Sambuanga.
Oo. Pagka lumabas ang isang issue, magkakaroon na naman ng grupo. Against that, magpo-form na naman ng grupo.
Another group.
So, dumadami ang grupo, dumadami ang issue. Ang solusyon sa lahat ng issue is yung People's Initiative. To gather 5.5 million signatures from registered voters for all of the issues. Can you imagine? If all of these issues will be brought to the people to sign, I will ask you to sign five issues.
Ito isa lang.
No, the ito, people will be...
Ito one time, big time. We will ask all of these groups to focus be to one, me. Focus on one, which is one time, big time, which all of these issues will be taken up. On the day that it is going to be taken up after the referendum, after the elections of the Constitutional Convention. Ngayon, lahat itong grupo na against the FOI, they will now all concentrate.
Yun ang didibat.
Yun ang babantayan nila, yung FOI. Kami sa dynasty, babantayan namin yung political dynasties. Diyan kami makikipag-away sa mga oppositors yan. In other words, ito tao na against those corrupt officials. Sino mananalo?
It's similar to the group.
And besides, Harry, if you mind. And besides, this constitution is already 26 years old.
Tama.
If you remember, the constitution of Marcos, that was in 1971.
16 years old.
And it was replaced by 1987 constitution.
Correct.
That is only about appointed by Cory. All the delegates there were appointed by Cory. And this is already 16. Minadali yun. So in other words, itong 87 constitution, I think, pase na to. I mean, it's not up to the time now. Because this constitution, 87, I think, one of the reasons why they have the constitution, para parosahan yung mga nagnao against martial law. Hindi talaga pinag-isipan ito. Parang vengativo ito, constitution na ito. So, ito, with this now, normal times now, I think it's the best time now to change this our constitution para to address the issues at present and in the future.
Not only the issues, Harry, pati yung mga flawed constitutional provisions, katulad itong dynasty. Di ba merong gray area doon na yun ang ginamit ng mga politiko.
Article 2, Section 26.
Right.
So ang kulang lang doon yung enabling law.
Enabling law.
So with the new one time, big time charter change, all of these things will have to be addressed. Diba? Ano sabi ni spokesman Abigail? We are just following what the Constitution states. What does it state?
It's called legal dictatorship. go ahead. Yeah.
So, yung mga ganong flaws, lahat yung ma-address lang na taong bayan. At saka we will succeed dahil ang tao ngayon talaga, they all agitated already. They all conscious about the issues. They know what the issues are all about. They know what is going to be the effect. And they should know. Now, we are telling them that we should band ourselves together to have one-time, big-time solution.
And it's high time now
to
change the constitution. It's about time.
This will be the last act that everybody concerned will have to take to change the political system.
This is the only solution to address all the issues.
All the issues.
At the same
time. And future issues also, because of course, yes. So in other words, the constitution that will be on the 20th, 21st century.
Correct.
Ito ang dapat natin.
Yung mga Muslim issues nila. Kung sino mga issues nila. Yung mga religious organizations will be one. Hindi lang isang effort ng Catholic Church o ng Christians o ng Muslims. Hindi. Lahat to. We'll have to join together. So, it will be perfect. Yeah. It will be one. One time, big time.
And a lot of time is saved. A lot of time is saved. At mababantayan natin to. We are only to focus to only one. For the first time, mag-unite ang Filipino dito for this issue to change talagang yung constitution that is adaptable to the present and the future.
Amen. Kinuha mo na lahat
Harry, ang detalye niyan, for one issue, meron kang isang form. Ito, provided by the COMELEC. Ito yung form na gagamitin mo. MAD. To gather all the signatures, 5.6 signatures. Yan ang gagamitin mo. Ngayon, itong mga grupo to, FOI. They will have the same form. Pero ang issue nila, FOI. And so on and so forth. Ngayon, lima na tayo. Now, you are the voter. I'll come to you.
You'll be confused.
Just choose one. It doesn't matter.
Multiple choice.
Ito ngayon, lahat tayo ngayon, together, we have only one. One form. People's initiative.
Okay, we're at the bottom of the hour. We're going to have to take a short break. Ladies and gentlemen, now that we've identified one time, big time, meaning a charter change, bubuksan natin ang ligang batas at pag-aaralan natin at papalitan natin. But, how do we go about it? Let's see. Initiative, we use the COMELEC. If only Snow White wasn't there. And we get the COMELEC to come out with a movement that says the people want an initiative, so we do away with Congress. Okay, the questions there are going to be, but what about the 80% dynasties that sit in Congress? What about the puppets that sit in the COMELEC that use PICOS as the magic machine to turn the vote of the people around to say otherwise? Ladies and gentlemen, when you watch TV, when you read the newspapers, it is now no longer the one-off article or the one-off broadcaster. Even on mainstream media and Channel 2. I'm surprised even Ted Filon and all the big supposedly mainstream media editorialists or broadcast editors are all screaming out because we have problems. Ladies and gentlemen, ang mga problema ng Pilipinas ay totoo. Yung sinasabi nila, napakagaling natin, sinasabi ng buong mundo, we are the rising tiger. Sure, go to Pangasinan and check out the fishermen. You want to know how good we are? Let's go to Zamboanga and see how those people are coming out of their problems. Let us look at the price of rice. And we're not supposed to import or export any. We don't have an agricultural problem. There's just no food. We're doing so well. We have so much money, so much savings, that when we have a problem, we ask the general public, let's give them food. Let's go to the Red Cross, that's international. Hindi na po ganun ngayon eh. It is true, we're in trouble. That's why Malacanang is in panic. We'll be right back. Stay with us.
Well said.